Hello again, this is LaZouche Custom here. Okay, this is going to be another of my information book review videos. I believe I've done a couple in the past, or at least one anyway in the past, on books that, well, I found very, very interesting and worthy of note, and are worth spending your hard-earned cash on if you're a very, very, you know, good devotee of handguns. For airsoft or real steel. Now then, two books that have recently arrived in my possession are Massad Ayoob's Greatest Handguns of the World and the Gun Digest book of the 1911 Volume 2 by Patrick Sweeney. Now, I'll deal with Massad's book first. Now, this book, to give you a bit of a background history as to Massad Ayoob, he's a instructor in firearms, tactics and so forth, mainly to do with pistols, but he does do with other weapons as well, in the US. He's also an expert witness when it comes to court cases and so forth in regards to weapon-related crimes and so on. And he's also a law enforcement officer. I'm not sure whether he still is. I think he might be retired now, but he does know his stuff. And a little while back, Ed Brown Firearms produced a signature edition Massad Ayoob commander size pistol, which I made a replica of, which you may remember. Okay, cut to the chase. The book itself. Well, it's about what it says on the cover. It's the greatest handguns of the world, which are cover the Dirty Harry M29 or 44 Magnum, whatever you want to call it, to the small snub noses to 1911s. Now, the contents, you've got all sorts in here. You've got the King of Pistols, the 1911, the Colt Commander and its clones, the Colt National Match Pistol and its spiritual descendants, the Colt Detective Special, Colt's Official Police Special, the Colt Python, the Colt Woodsman. You've got all sorts in here. It's not just Colts, by the way. It's Smith & Wesson, H&K. There's some quite interesting stuff in here. Now, those of you who are purists and only like 1911 stuff, then this book might not really be for you, because pretty much only, only about that much of it is to do with the 1911. The rest is all other pistols, such as the Colt Detective Special, you've got all sorts in here. You've got Smith & Wesson Revolvers, you've got the Python, you've got the Colt Woodsman, you've got, if you're a Glock person, you'll enjoy this, because he does love his Glocks. He's got a whole section on Glocks, which is really, really interesting, actually. I'm not a Tupperware person, but I quite enjoyed his read. It's very, very good. You've got the High Standard. You've also got H&K, by the way. I went past them, actually. I should have showed you that. You've got the H&K History of Innovation. They actually had the first Tupperware pistol. Everyone thinks it was Glock. It wasn't. It was H&K. You've got High Standard. What else have you got in here? You've got the Luger pistol, which is really interesting again. It's very, very good indeed. You've got loads of stuff in here. Section there? You've got the Ruger 22 auto pistol, another exceptionally good pistol. Now, his writing's pretty good. Oh, you've also got the Ruger P-Series semi-automatics, which are very, very good. They actually became like a standard pistol and outsold most other automatics, which I didn't know, in America, real steel, for law enforcement and so forth. You've got Smith & Wesson's military and police revolvers, which are very, very good. You've got loads of stuff in there. Smith & Wesson K22. Where's Dirty Harry's one in here? Smith & Wesson 2 Special and Family. But there's Dirty Harry's one in here somewhere. 357 Combat Magnum. You've got that one, which is another nice pistol. Sorry about the lighting. It keeps reflecting on this book. But what else have you got in here? Try and find Dirty Harry's one. Model 27. We're getting there. We're getting there. Highway Patrolman. No, maybe not. There's loads of different ones in here. I mean, he even gives you when accidents happen. I mean, this is a solid framed pistol, and yet look, you've blown the top out. So yeah, that's putting too high power a load in a revolver, and it's hard to destroy a revolver. Look at that. Look, blown the chamber right out. Anyway, yeah, there's loads of stuff in here. There we go. There's the dirty Harry ones, I think. Yeah, 44 Magnum. There we go. So you got the dirty Harry pistol in here, which is very good indeed. He goes on about compensators. And yeah, it's an interesting book. His reading can be a little bit, what should I say, technical at times. Well, not technical, but he knows so much about what he's talking about that sometimes, I mean, he lost me a couple of times and I was like, what? And I had to sort of research what he meant to find out what he meant in regards to what he'd written. So it can be a little bit confusing now and again, unless you're a real pistolero type person and know what he's going on about. But there's some lovely pictures in here. There's also a bit of history about pistols he's owned. The Colt National Match pistol, which was really, really good. Now, I have another book by Patrick Sweeney called The First 100 Years of the Colt 1911, which is an exceptionally good book. But there are bits in that. Remember, he's skating over the history. Well, not skating over it, because he does go in depth. But there are little bits that get missed or overlooked or not really discussed that much. This book sort of filled in the blanks for me with regards to certain things about the National Match pistol and other brands and so forth, which, yeah, helps. It does help a lot. So there you go. You've got the Colt Commander. You've got all sorts in here, which, yeah, where was it? There was one bit in here I did. Oh, and you've got a bit of the history, which I like, of all the innovations that came in with regards to the 1911 right up to 2011. So it's an up-to-date book. This is right up to, well, 2 years ago. So it's pretty much up to date. You've got loads of stuff on Kimbers and how reliable they are, supposedly. you've got loads of stuff in here. You've got the Colt 1911 double action, which never really got anywhere, which was a double eagle. But no one seemed to like it. Yeah, there's loads of information in here. So it's a nice little book. He talks about Smith & Wesson 1911s, which, to be honest, are some of the best on the market, real steel, that is. I enjoyed this book. I really did. Luckily enough, I like the feature on Amazon where they allow you to look at some of the inner pages before you buy, because it's no use just going on the outer cover, because sometimes they can make the outer cover look fantastic. When you get it and you start reading it, you think, oh my God, this is boring me silly. This didn't. It does, you know, has done and still does keep me interested. I still not read this book entirely all the way through from cover to cover, because there is so much in here. And I'm not really into revolvers at the moment, but I am reading them through slowly. In regards to HK pistols, very innovative. Some of the information in there is fantastic. I really, really enjoyed reading that section. The Ruger section is exceptionally good. Yeah, there's loads in there. So I'd well recommend that. If you're into the historical side, how to shoot, grip, tactics and so forth, they can be, or at least some of it can be transferred to airsoft. But it's me. I'm a stickler for history and, you know, information with regards to real steel pistols, and also for the pictures in here as well. They're all colour pictures. It's not like some of the other books I've got, which are just black and white. These are colour, so they do give you a hell of a lot more detail. But it's mainly for the history side of it and for odd tales and stories associated with some of the people that Massad has encountered in his lifetime, which I found very, very interesting indeed. So there you go. So that's that book. So yeah, highly recommended. I really recommend that book. It's well worth the money. Which I think was about, I think I paid about 16 quid for that, I think. So yeah, it wasn't too bad value-wise. Now then, this is the other book. This is by Patrick Sweeney again. Excellent writer. Very, very good indeed. He's the one who wrote the 1911, The First 100 Years, which is a later book to this. This is an earlier one. He writes for numerous different publications, Gun Digest, Guns and Ammo, there's loads of other ones he writes, and he writes under his own name as well. Anyway, Volume 1 I managed to look at on Amazon, but I couldn't see inside it, unfortunately. They haven't updated their page for that particular book, so I couldn't see inside it. But I managed to look inside Volume 2, because that page on Amazon allowed me to see inside and look at some of the pictures. And I thought, ooh, that looks interesting. So I decided to buy. Again, this come to about, I think this was about £19, I think, because it is quite a thick book and there's loads of information in there. I personally found it a really, really good read. I've only read through to, well, I've dipped in, let's put it that way, here and there. But I've started to solidly read it now, and I think I've got up to about, where is it, up to that page. So I've only got a little way in. But I have dipped in, you know, had a quick scan through, and so far I've not been disappointed. It's all black and white inside, unfortunately, but that doesn't detract from the overall information that's included. I mean, there's loads of info with regards to 1911s, bullet weights and all stuff like that. I mean, it's real steel stuff, don't get me wrong. It's not for airsoft, really. But if you need details as to what logos are marked on this, that and the other, sight types, all stuff like this, which is handy if you're customising pistols to get them exactly right to the real steel, this is an absolute goldmine of information. It really, really is. So yeah, for airsofting, it's fantastic. It really is good. At least so far with what I've scanned through and read. Now, in regards to information, I mean, you've got gunsmith speak. Now, as I mentioned on the previous book, Massad Ayoob's book, I was a little unsure here and there as to what he was actually describing in his writing, because he knows his stuff and he expects, you know, real steel writers or readers to know what he's on about. This treats you not as an idiot, don't get me wrong, but it treats you in a way that is very layman's terms, and gunsmith speak, this whole section is really, really handy because it gives you an insight into what gunsmiths are actually talking about when they talk about headspace and or this, that and the other. It doesn't make you feel as if you're a stranger in a strange land. It does really, really sort of give you a lot of insight. Now, I'm talking to you guys, I know, as airsofters, but I mean, if any of you real steel guys are actually watching these videos, Lord knows why, but if you are, I recommend this book. I mean, the same as Massad Ayoob's books or any of the other books that I've got for real steel users as well. They're an absolute wealth of information. They really are. I mean, Patrick Sweeney is, I think, if not the best writer on real steel weaponry, pistols and so forth. He's exceptionally good. His AR stuff is very good as well. If you're into M4s and M16s and so forth, he writes on those as well. And they're very, very good. So as I say, I've scanned through it. There's loads of information, absolutely tons of it. There's a quick note on finishes, Cerakotes, polymer finishes, all sorts, grips, everything, absolutely everything. Who were the innovators, who weren't? There's loads of stuff in here. I mean, some of the stuff I'm not quite sure on, like that Marvel conversion, I'm not sure about that. But the magazines, the different magazine buffers and the different innovators in the magazine side of things, sights, what are good sights, what are bad sights, everything. It's just fantastic. It really is. Colt, how they've developed over the years, or not developed as they did back in the 80s, but there you are. Rock Island Armory, which actually are made, I think, in the Philippines, and they're a cheap brand, but they're actually gaining, you know, quite a lot of good standing now. Dan Wesson, which are owned by CZ in Czechoslovakia, but they're actually made in America. I mean, there's loads of different ones here. Kimber, you've got Kimber in here as well. He does all the different brands, or at least majority of them. I think there's about 24 brands he deals with in this particular volume, whereas in the previous one, it was AMT and some of the earlier manufacturers of 1911s, Randall and so forth. What I like is the pictures, instead of just like a bland one side, two side, that's it. No, he gives you detailed pictures. He tells you whether they've got lanyard loops, how many cutouts are in the riz rail, and the sight types, hammers, you name it, it's in here. It's all there. So if you really want to go to town, then you can. And of course, he does my favourite, Les Bayer. He's really, really good. Some of the info that he's got here is fantastic. He deals with single pistols, by the way, with each manufacturer. He doesn't like go through their entire line. He just deals with single examples from that manufacturer, which is a bit handicapping, but it's not too bad. It's quite good. I quite enjoyed reading or scanning through so far. So there you are. But again, well worth the buy. If you're real steel, I mean, there's bullet information, there's loading information, there's penetration, for want of a word. There's loads of stuff in here. There's how to strip down, how to use lubricants and so forth, what are the best lubricants, what are the best finishes, mud, dust test, drills to practice. He covers pretty much everything in here, even from small carbines as well. He covers pretty much everything. And also to gunsmithing skills as well, checking your engagement, whatever that is. I presume that's sear and so forth. Hood fit on your 1911, uplift or slide fit. See, a lot of this to me is, because I'm an airsofter, it's like, what the hell is he on about? Well, as I've read into it, he tells you what all that means, and it's really, really interesting, if you're a geek like me. So there's a lot of info in there, and I highly recommend anything by Patrick Sweeney. He writes for the reader instead of just for other experts that know what the hell you're talking about, if you know what I mean. He's a very open guy, very sort of down to earth, and not too smarmy about it. Well, no, smarmy is the wrong word, but he's more in a layman's terms and gets the information across far better. Whereas Massad Ayoob, he's very direct, to the point. Still good, still pretty good, don't get me wrong, but there's a lot of the times when he runs away with information and you're like, what? And yeah, you have to sort of research a little bit to find out what he's on about. Only occasionally though, not all the time. He's pretty good, as I say, in this book. And I recommend, highly recommend both of them if you're a dedicated pistol person, let's put it that way, who likes his historical side, his little anecdotes and stuff like that, that especially my Massad Ayoob and Patrick Sweeney, and you like the historical side and the real steel side to it. If you're just a pure airsofter and just want information on how to make your gun better or whatever, yeah, maybe these are not the real thing for you. You need more stuff that's aimed towards airsoft. But if you're like me, a bit of a geek, like to read as well as and research and get things just so, then yeah, I recommend these books. Part one, I should imagine, is just as good as part two. As I say, it was the earlier types of 1911s that were available that he reviews in that book, whereas this book he reviews Kimber, Wilson Combat, and Springfield Armour, and all those, the later ones, so Les Baer and so forth. So there you go. So hopefully that's given you a little bit more of a reader's insight into what's available out there. I mean, there's not only just these books, there's loads of other books out there, but these are the ones that I've found myself and researched on and found to be about the best. They can be a tad expensive. I mean, as I say, that was about £19. I think this one was about £16 on Amazon. But I mean, there are cheaper ones available. You can buy them read on Amazon, i.e. used or whatever. Be careful when buying used. Excuse me. Be careful when buying used books. Make sure that you read the description before you buy, because otherwise you'll get a book with all of the corners folded over, tea stains on it, and God knows what else. So be careful. If you're like me, I prefer a new book because I look after my books well, like they're my children, I do look after them a lot and treat them well. But so be careful. If you're not too worried about condition or whatever, then fair enough. But you can pick up some of these books for quite reasonable prices, if not ridiculously reasonable. I believe there's some books on there for like a penny. All you got to pay for is just the blooming postage costs. But anyway, whether it includes these or not, I don't know. But yeah, so as I say, when you're buying the books, I personally go for new books. But there are, if you know, money is tight, but you do want a book, then just go for the used ones. But be careful. All right. Okay, well, thanks for watching. I hope I haven't bored you silly, but with my geekiness and nerdiness in liking these books, but there you are. As I say, if you're like me and want your pistol or 1911 or whatever to look exactly like the real thing, these books are real, real wealth of information, a gold mine, absolute gold mine. That said, the internet is also another huge free gold mine of information, so never dismiss the internet. But if you like, on a winter's night, like it is at the moment, and with a warm cup of tea or whatever, hot cup of tea or something stronger, sit down, cover up on the old sofa, and have a read or whatever of one of these, or in bed at night, whatever, have a read. And yeah, it's good. As the old saying goes, a good companion is a book. And it's true, it is. Okay, guys. Anyway, thanks for watching. And as I say, I'll put some links hopefully in the description below, if I remember. Sometimes I say that and I never put a bloody link in there, but yeah, I'll try to remember this time. If you've got any questions, whatever, then obviously answer below, post below. But yeah, I'll put some links in there for the links to the Amazon pages for these books, if I can. I'm not sure whether I can actually, but I'll try. And some other reviews, so it's unbiased. You'll see what others think of these books. All right. Okay, well, this is LaZouche Custom saying stay sharp, but stay safe, and thanks for watching. Bye for now.